Good evening and welcome to the Cathedral of St. Agnes. My name is Father Duffy, I'm the rector here, and on behalf of our Bishop John Barris, the priest of the cathedral, and our parishioners, allow me to welcome each and every one of you. What a joy it is to be together during this holy season of Advent, to be gathered for this wonderful event this evening. This event that doesn't just occur, but takes such tremendous work and effort of our music department, of Mr. Bauer, of Miss Goodwin, of so many people, but especially of our musicians, our performers this evening. Thank you all for being together with us this evening as we listen to Handel's Messiah, which presents to us through the words of sacred scripture a preparation for the coming of Christ at the end of time and at Christmas. And so I invite you to join with me in prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. As I have said so many times before, cathedrals through the centuries have been places of encountering culture and being enriched by culture. I'm so very pleased that this evening is such one of those evenings, that tonight we can encounter culture, music, beauty, dignity, and together prepare for the coming of the Lord. Thank you, and you are most welcome for being here this evening.
Thank you, Father Duffy. Well, good evening, everyone. It is a pleasure, a joy, and a privilege to be here this evening and present this concert. Oh, I've been here a long time and a million stories I could tell about being a scared, a little 21-year-old coming from undergrad school in Princeton to this incredible town, this parish, this community, this diocese, the people that I've met, the priests that I've worked with. So a journey to present this concert to all of you tonight, and so many people to thank. We could be here for another 4 hours. We're preparing for Christmas. We're in the Advent season, but we have to sing a couple of Christmas carols to help us prepare for Christmas. So starting off, we're going to sing O Come All Ye Faithful, or Adeste Fidelis. You probably know it. It's in the hymnal there if you'd like to join in. So, and then we'll continue with the first part of the Messiah. And boy, are you in for a treat. These spectacular solos, the orchestra superb, and my sublime choir that works so hard for me each and every time they come together. We will take an intermission, so after O Thou That Tellest, you'll have a chance to stretch. There's a restroom in the back here, and then just across the way. So community, that's what we are, all together, the orchestra, the soloist, the choir. So please say hello to whomever is sitting near you. Again, thank you so much for being here tonight.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, thank you all so much. I said in the program about kindly not clapping, but it happens at the opera all the time. People just get so excited about these beautiful voices. We were so excited. This was like Christmas already for me this week that I could barely sleep. So thank you for your enthusiasm. It's the joy of great music in a great space and a great evening to be together. So we'll stand up and stretch a little bit. And there are restrooms, as I mentioned, in the choir if they want to rest their feet for a little bit. So see you back in about 10. Thank you. I hate to stop the performance. At the end, we're going to have each one of the solos come back up so you can really applaud for each one. But that is the most athletic singing, the piece that you just heard. All of this music, it's very hard music. Of the 18th century, we were moving into mechanical things. Technology was sort of forming at that time. Different clocks and different devices. And so the music is very technical, too. So what they're doing tonight, we think athletes are something special. This singing is athletic. I'm sorry to stop that, but I just had to comment that that's an incredibly hard piece to sing.
Ears of the deaf unstopped, then shall
Who needs Carnegie? What a gift, what a joy to be together tonight and to make a glorious sound unto God. When King George heard the Hallelujah chorus for the first time, he couldn't help but stand for two things: because of the beauty of the music and because of the truth of the words that were sung. My friends, you have made a glorious sound unto God. You have filled this cathedral with beautiful music, with beautiful words. Mr. Bauer, your gift, your talent. Let's thank him. To all those in our choir, those who can't be seen, the little ones, the big ones, those who are seated, what a gift to have you here today to just move our hearts. I'm without words. What a gift. And to all the benefactors and sponsors of this evening that have helped to make this possible. This doesn't just happen. This took weeks upon weeks of work. Thank you to all that made this happen. And permit me, on behalf of Bishop Barris, through the intercession of St. Agnes, to wish each and every one of you a very special and blessed Advent and blessed Christmas season. And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Merry Christmas, everyone.
So, will we have you all standing? So we're going to sing Hark the Herald. So please join in with that too. And I think our young choristers maybe have some presentations right now. We'll do that right now too. Miss Goodwin, she has to come back for a second as well. So as I met, lots of training. So the two men, our tenor and bass, who went through the boys' choir from little boys, one from Manhasset and one from right here from St. Agnes. Emmett came down with his brother, and he was this little curly-haired boy, and James, his older brother, was all excited, and now he's become quite the big star, as well as Eric and Daniel, who's quite the superstar too in teaching down in Texas. I learned so much from him the last few days, into our beautiful female singers as well. Look for them and their careers coming up to sing in many more places, as well as in St. Agnes Cathedral. Here we go, one Christmas carol for the evening, and thank you all again so much. Hark the Herald.